Good morning. Let us continue with the theory of turbo machines. So far, we have discussed the introduction part of the turbo machines. I will quickly go through the contents or the topics which we have covered in the introduction. So we have started with the classification of turbo machine, the definitions. Then we have drawn the velocity triangle and we have derived the expression for the power developed, okay, namely the Euler equation. Then we have defined various efficiencies, then also the degree of reaction. Meanwhile, we have discussed the importance of static and stagnation properties, okay. And we have drawn the HS diagram, enthalpy entropy diagrams, and the nozzle and diffuser configurations. So the area, how the area of a diffuser and nozzle should be for the subsonic and supersonic flow conditions. So for that we derived an expression for the area dA, change in area dA, in terms of change in pressure and Mach number, etc. And finally we have touched upon the critical properties. So the mass flow rate increases with decrease in outlet pressure, and at some point of pressure ratio the flow through the nozzle is going to be maximum. So that pressure ratio is known as critical pressure ratio, and all other properties corresponding to that state, okay, where you have attained the maximum flow rate, is known as the critical properties. And the condition here of maximum flow rate is otherwise known as choked flow, okay. So with further decrease in pressure, okay, outlet pressure, you cannot have further increase in the what you call as the mass flow rate, okay. So that is known as a choked flow. So these are the things we have seen so far, the turbo machines, okay, as the introduction. So now let me move to namely unit number 4, okay. So it is just for the sake of convenience, I am skipping the units, okay. So it is better to understand very easily the concept of turbines first, because it is a power generating machine. So it is very easy for us. So work developed by the machines will be positive. So W is going to be positive in case of turbines. And after understanding the concept of turbine, it is better to go to the concept of compressors. Okay, so as of now I am skipping unit 2 and 3 and I am jumping to unit 4, so which deals with the turbine, namely axial and radial flow turbines, okay. Yeah, so this is unit number 4. You can see here unit number 4, okay, design and analysis of turbo machines. We are going to discuss about the axial and radial flow turbines. So first let me introduce you regarding the axial flow turbine. So we know that by classification, so unit 1 introduction we have classified the machines. So there we have classified axial flow machines in which the fluid will flow parallel to the axis of the shaft. So it's going to move parallel to the axis of the shaft. So that is known as the axial flow machine. And here we are going to talk about the turbine, which is the power generating machine, that's all. And essentially this axial flow turbines consists of fixed and moving blades. It consists of fixed and moving blades. Fixed blades are otherwise known as stator blades, and moving blades otherwise known as rotor blades. Okay. Now the stator blade, okay, is also called as nozzle. Okay. So it is a fixed blade or stator blade. Sometimes it is referred as nozzle. Okay. Particularly in impulse turbine. Impulse turbine, that fixed blade or stationary blade is nothing but the nozzle. And nozzle, the function, the importance or the use of nozzle, we have discussed in unit 1, okay, which is going to convert the pressure energy of the fluid into the kinetic energy, okay. So the purpose of the nozzle here in axial flow turbine is to supply high kinetic energy fluid, okay. Next is the rotor blade, okay, rotor or the moving blade. So before that, okay, this in reaction turbines, okay, in reaction turbine, the fixed blade is known as the guide blade, okay. So it is used to guide the flow, so it is used to direct the flow, okay, so in the required angle, okay, in order to impinge, to make the fluid impinge on the say the moving blade, you have an arrangement called guide blade. So it will guide the flow. So it is not a nozzle, it is simply a guide blade in reaction termite. So these things is these concepts are very important. So it consists of a stator and a moving blade, okay, and the stator is nothing but a nozzle in the case of impulse turbine, and it is a fixed guide blade in the case of reaction turbine. So remember, reaction turbine uses both pressure energy and kinetic energy, so only there you are not having nozzle, okay, whereas impulse machine uses only kinetic energy, so it uses a nozzle, okay. Next is a turbine stage. What is a turbine stage? A turbine stage usually refers to a set of fixed and moving blade. So you have a nozzle and a moving blade, you have a guide blade and a moving blade, so this two put together is a set, okay, and this set of fixed and moving blade is known as a turbine stage. So a single stage of a turbine will have one fixed blade and one moving blade. If it is a two stage turbine, you have two fixed blade and two moving blade and so on, okay. So stage means it includes one fixed and one moving blade, okay. And you can see here, next comes the multi-stage turbine. So it is going to have several sets of fixed and moving blade, already I have explained it. So then in axial flow turbines, another important thing is axial flow, we have defined the flow is parallel to the axis of the shaft, which means at the inlet of the blade and the outlet of the blade, the radius, okay, from the center of the say axis is going to be same, or the height at which the fluid enters and leaves is going to be in the same plane, which means there is no effect of radius at inlet and radius at outlet. Because of that, the blade speed remains constant. Blade speed remains constant, which is U is equal to constant. We have already defined this U is as blade speed while we discuss the velocity triangle. So the blade velocity is constant. How is U becoming constant? Because U, you know, it is pi dN by 60, where D is the diameter of the rotor and N is the rotor speed. And diameter here, there is no effect at inlet and outlet, so diameter remains constant. So there is no point in putting pi d1 n by 60 and pi d2 n by 60, both are same in case of axial, because the flow is happening parallel to the axis. There is no effect of heights at inlet and outlet from the center of axis. So that is what I have indicated here. The fluid enters and leaves at the same radii. From the radii means the height from the center of the axis, okay. So these are some of the fundamental things you have to remember about the axial flow turbines. Next is axial flow impulse turbines. So we are going to be very particular about the impulse turbine first, okay. So because the unit is axial and radial flow turbines, okay. So few points which I have discussed just now, it is nothing but the basic things about the axial flow machine, okay. Now we are going to be very particular about the impulse turbine. So you know that the impulse turbine uses only kinetic energy, so whereas in reaction turbine uses both kinetic energy and pressure energy, okay. So it has a nozzle and moving blade. So already I have explained you in the basic definition here, initially I have given, okay, stator and moving blade, nozzle will be present in impulse turbine. So in impulse turbine we will have nozzle and moving blade. So this is one stage of a turbine. So next is what happens in the nozzle. If you see, okay, in the nozzle the pressure of the working medium or the fluid decreases. So you know this, the fundamental definition of a nozzle, it is going to convert the pressure energy, okay. So if it is going to convert the pressure energy, the pressure has to decrease, and the converted form is the kinetic energy, the velocity increases, okay. So hence high velocity of the fluid will be leaving the nozzle, So then what happens next, you see, the fluid with whatever that has left the nozzle will be striking the moving blade, will be striking the moving blade, because you have fixed and the moving blade. So the fluid which has left the moving blade will now impinge or strike or hit the moving blade. Okay, so now when it hits the moving blade will try to move. What happens now? What is happening now? The fluid is transferring its energy. So the fluid is having full of kinetic energy, and that energy is getting transferred to the blade. So only the blade is moving. So in the moving blade, the velocity of the fluid is converted to the mechanical work. Okay, so this is the working principle. Okay, construction wise, it consists of a nozzle and moving blade. Okay, and working principle, what happens to the nozzle? Pressure of the working fluid decreases, velocity of the working fluid increases. What happens to the moving blade? In the moving blade, the velocity of the fluid is extracted, okay, and it is given to the blade. So the blade rotates. So the blade is now having mechanical form of energy. So initially, the fluid is having some form of energy in say pressure energy form. Then that pressure energy is converted to kinetic energy form in the fluid only. Okay. Next, when it comes to the moving blade, the energy possessed, kinetic energy possessed by the fluid is converted to the mechanical work. Okay. So this is the working principle. So you can see here below, I have shown the here in this diagram. Okay, the highlighted diagram here. You can see here this diagram shows the arrangement of a nozzle and a fixed plate. Moving blade. Okay, so we have drawn this moving blade. You know, it's a curved blade, and just before the blade, you have a nozzle. So now this becomes the inlet of the moving blade, and this becomes the outlet of the moving blade. Okay, so I have extended some lines. Okay, dashed lines I have shown here, and I have shown here the variation of pressure of the working medium and velocity of the working medium. Let us take first the pressure of the working medium. So when the fluid enters the nozzle, so that is here at the left extreme point, what I am showing now is the inlet to the nozzle. Okay, I am using a converging type of nozzle. Okay, so the the pressure of the working medium at the inlet of the nozzle is high. So take some arbitrary axis. So this let us have this as the y-axis, this as the x-axis. So I have some high pressure. Okay, this means some arbitrary units, pressure is high. So the fluid is entering with high pressure. Once it enters the nozzle, the pressure decreases. You can see downward trend of line is shown. Pressure decreases. Where it happens? Within the nozzle area. Okay, so within these two dashed line, it is the nozzle area. So in the nozzle area, the pressure decreases. Then what happens is the fluid passes through the moving blade. Notice here the pressure is remaining constant. We have a horizontal line. We have a horizontal line, which means the pressure remains constant. Pressure remaining constant. Okay. Now, why? Because the pressure is remaining constant? Because we are talking about an impulse machine. In impulse machine, the pressure will remain constant. Okay. Now, what happens to the velocity of the fluid? You see, at the inlet of the nozzle, the velocity is low. Whereas at the outlet of the nozzle, the velocity is getting increased. You can notice here, the pressure is getting a downward trend, showing a downward trend, whereas the velocity is showing an upward trend, which means there is an increase in velocity, okay, due to the decrease in pressure energy. Okay. Now, at the inlet of the moving blade, somewhere here, so I am showing here with the cursor, okay, you can see here, at the inlet of the moving blade, the fluid is having high velocity. And as it moves through the moving blade, as the fluid moves moving blade, it transfers